Hi, I'm Jared, and it'll be my pleasure today to take you through this virtual tour of the Herefordshire Beacon here in Worcestershire, England. In England's Western Midlands is a range of hills designated as the Malvern Hills area of outstanding natural beauty. Centuries before Christ, ancient Britons built protective fortifications atop of these hills to ward off invaders. Hikers today can still see the remnants of this British camp. But members of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints revere this hilltop for another event, which took place in 1840, which was a year a new Christian faith was revitalizing the local area with religious excitement. Elder Wilford Woodruff, a missionary of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints from America, arrived here in early March, preaching what he called the restored gospel of Jesus Christ, United Brethren Christians who were looking for a return to biblical principles were among those most prepared to embrace his message. This restoration of which Elder Woodruff taught, though similar to Reformation faiths, introduced the idea of a new gospel dispensation in which heavenly interactions between God and man empowered a restoration of divine authority, keys, and truths which had been lost or altered throughout the centuries. My friend Felicity will now tell you more.
Through these restored priesthood keys and a restored priesthood organisation, Elder Woodruff had been ordained an apostle for the Lord Jesus Christ. In fact, 8 of the 12 apostles in 1840 recently arrived in Britain. So a conference was convened April 14th in Preston's Cockpit, also known as the Temperance Hall. Meeting with these church leaders were others from among the nearly 1,700 local converts to this faith. The conference reviewed progress made in Britain and outlined steps for further growth. Though a new hymnal had recently been published in America, few copies made it to Britain, and many of those hymns were less appropriate here. So one of their resolutions was to publish a book of British hymns. It was also decided that a monthly periodical could really benefit local members by explaining church doctrines and chronicling news of the church both here and abroad. A third resolution called for securing the copyright to both the Book of Mormon and the Book of Doctrine and Covenants so a future printing of them could one day be accomplished here. For the present, however, they would concentrate on printing the hymnal and periodical, which they named Latter-day Saints Millennial Star. Following the conference, Brigham Young wrote to Joseph Smith in America to secure those copyrights. Then he and Willard Richards joined Wilford Woodruff back in the Malvern area to assist in efforts there.
On the 11th of May in 1840, while hiking through these hills for a teaching appointment, Elder Wilford Woodruff ascended to the highest point of the Malverns, an anciently fortified hilltop known as the Herefordshire Beacon. The curious battle entrenchments which circled the summit were reminiscent of several civilization-ending battlegrounds which featured prominently in the pages of the Book of Mormon. Without access to this important book, area converts were being deprived of the many assurances that come from reading its inspired pages, and many petitioned for it daily. These missionaries taught some unique religious concepts, such as the existence of a living prophet on the earth today, of a continuing flow of revelation from God, and of a growing canon of scripture.
The Book of Mormon is part of that growing canon. It's an ancient Christian text that increases man's knowledge and understanding of Jesus Christ and his gospel. It has been regarded as scripture by Latter-day Saints since its first printing in 1830. It does not in any way replace or run contrary to the Bible, but is a sacred companion volume to be used in tandem with it. While the Bible speaks of God's dealings anciently with mankind on the Eastern Hemisphere, the Book of Mormon expands the Lord's reach and speaks prophetically of his dealings anciently with mankind on the Western Hemisphere. The doctrines taught in both books are synergistic and complementary.
The desire for a local printing of the Book of Mormon faced two major obstacles, the first being funding and the second being permission. In those days, communication was very slow, and the prophet Joseph Smith had not yet replied to Brigham Young's inquiries as to the copyright and local publication of the record. How could they go on? After spending the night of May 13th here, in the John and Jane Bembo home, Brother Bembo handed Wilford Woodruff the huge 19th century sum of 200 British pounds, which John and Jane specifically earmarked for the publishing of the Book of Mormon. They knew how important that book was to the work here. The following week, after a priesthood blessing resulted in the miraculous healing of the invalid Mary Pitt, her grateful brother Thomas Kington, who had been the leader of the United Brethren before his own conversion, added another £100 to this total for the same purpose.
On May 20th, 1840, now with 300 British pounds in hand, Wilford Woodruff took his fellow apostles, Brigham Young and Willard Richards, to the top of the Herefordshire Beacon to have what is now known as the Beacon Conference. Finding themselves alone amidst the top of this summit, away from the crowds and noise, the three knelt together as missionaries and apostles of the Lord Jesus Christ and prayerfully implored the Lord for his divine guidance in this important matter. Joseph Smith referred to this book as the keystone of our religion and added, "Take away the Book of Mormon and the Revelations, and where is our religion? We have none."
After prayer, they felt divinely assured that they should proceed. They decided to use the £300 to print 3,000 copies of the Book of Mormon and support financially the hymnal and the periodical which were being prepared. Leaving Willard Richards and Wilford Woodruff to continue preaching locally, Brigham Young descended the hill straight for Manchester with the funds necessary for printing. Apostle Parley P. Pratt had already started working on the Millennial Star with a Manchester printer, but for printing the Book of Mormon, Brigham Young instead settled on a printer in Liverpool. The request for nearly 3,000 copies was doubled almost to 5,000, though only 4,050 were printed.
Since that time, this book has gone through a myriad of additional printings, both locally and abroad, with over 192 million copies printed, as well as providing many options for digital access. 142 years after this Liverpool printing in 1982, an additional British printing occurred, this time at the famed Cambridge University Press. For this printing, the title of the Book of Mormon was appended to add the descriptive words, "Another Testament of Jesus Christ," for that it truly is.
On the day following the creation of the Birmingham, England stake several decades ago, another modern-day apostle, Spencer W. Kimball, climbed this same summit with his wife, Camilla. Looking out over the breathtaking expanse below, he prophetically declared, "This is a place where the blood of Israel is richly concentrated, and there are still many to gather." Perhaps he spoke of you. The Book of Mormon has now been published in over 116 languages. We invite you to examine it for yourself, whatever language is most comfortable for you. We will leave a link near the bottom of this page where you can see if your desired language is available and a QR code to have the book easily installed on your device or sent to you should you desire. I've really enjoyed reading it many times and I'm inspired with each reading. Through my own experience, I have come to know that it is true.
Thank you for your time today. We hope you will discover this book for yourself. I know too that it is true. It can change your life for good.
May the Spirit of the Lord guide you in all truth.